Again, welcome to the class of thermodynamic. Now we will start with the first law of thermodynamic. Thermodynamics. If we will see the result of Joule's law, the result of the Joule's law, it was proof for a closed system undergoing a cycle the net work done is equal to net heat transfer in the cycle. If we will see the net heat transfer in the cycle will be equal to net work transfer in the cycle. This is valid for reversible as well as irreversible cycle. Now we will see the application or the most important application of first law of thermodynamic. These applications are very much important for understand the concept of the basic thermodynamic. Now first of all we will see the first application of the first law. The first application of the first law, it proved that heat transfer is a path function and it is inexact differential. Let's consider the first law of thermodynamic for a cycle. This is the process point 1, and from point 1 to A is a path and this is state 2, and again from 1 to 2 it will follow the path B. Then according to first law of thermodynamic, the cyclic integral or the total net heat transfer in the system will be equal to the total work transfer in the system. Let's consider for a cycle. For a cycle 1A2 and 2B1. For the cycle 1A2B1, let's see the total heat transfer will be equal to dQ1A2 plus dQ2B1. I am not writing right now what is plus or what is minus. I am just writing what is the total algebraic summation of the heat. That will be equal to the heat work transfer in 1A2 plus the work transfer in 2B1. Again, I'll change the path of, that is your returning path of a cycle. Now the cycle is 1A2 and 2C1. For the cycle 1A2C1, again I'll apply the first law of thermodynamic. Then we will see dQ1A2 plus dQ2C1 is equal to dW1A2 plus dW2C1. I am writing W as a del W, but Q as a dQ, because about Q I don't know. It is the point function or path function. But when I'll solve the equation 1 and equation 2, solving the equation 1 and equation 2, we will find dQ to B1 minus dQ to C1 is equal to del W to B1 minus del W to C1. If we will see the right hand side of the equation, we will see the del Q to B1 minus del W, sorry, del W to B1 minus del W to C1 is not equal to 0. Because it is a path function. For the different path, the value of the W will be different. It means W to B1 will never equal to W to C1. But if we will check the right hand side, that is equal to left hand side, that is equal to right hand side, it means your del 2B1 will never equal to del 2C1. Only it is possible only when it will satisfy this equation, so that your del Q 2B1 minus del Q 2C1 will not equal to 0. So from this point, it is clear heat is also depend upon path. It means heat transfer is a path function, and it is star point inexact differential. Now we will see the second important application of first law of thermodynamics, that means internal energy is a property. If we will further extend the result of the equation 1 and 2, then we will see del Q 2B1 minus del W 2B1 is equal to del Q 2C1 minus del W 2C1. Again, del Q minus del W 2B1 is equal to del Q minus del W 2C1. It means from two path it is clear the difference of the heat and work, that is the difference of two path function, is same for the difference path, for the different path. It means it is clear that the difference of the heat and work is always a point function that will always depend upon the point, that will never depend upon the path. It must be a property of the system. And this del Q minus del W must be a property of the system, because it depends upon only point function, and this property is nothing but energy. It means the change of the heat and change of the work, and the difference of both is equal to change of a property, that is the change in the energy. But this E is equal to internal energy U plus kinetic energy plus potential energy. Now, neglecting these two energy, because we are studying at the microscopic level, so property of microscopic property of the system, so we'll neglect the kinetic and potential energy. So the del Q minus del W will be equal to du, and du is your internal, or this one is the first law of thermodynamics for the reversible and irreversible process. That is the main difference in the equation first and this equation. That equation was valid, or that law was valid for a cycle, but this is again first law of thermodynamics. This is valid for the reversible as well as irreversible cycle, where U is the internal energy, its unit is kilojoule, and it is extensive property. And the specific internal energy, that is small u, capital U upon m is equal to kilojoule per kg. That is your intensive property. The U of any gas is given as mCvT, or the change of internal energy will be given as mCvdT. Equation third. The application of first law of thermodynamics, that is your third application, the most important application of this one, that is state that energy of an isolated system is constant. Energy of isolated system is constant. According to the first law of thermodynamics, we know that del Q is equal to del W plus du. But for an isolated system, del Q is equal to del W is equal to zero. So dE for the isolated system will be equal to zero, or E1 is equal to E2. It means energy of an isolated system is always constant. It will never change in any process. And again, universe is an isolated system. So the energy of universe is constant. It does not change with any process. Then the fourth application of first law of thermodynamics for a closed system is your enthalpy. If we will check the first law of thermodynamics, that is your del Q is equal to del W plus du. It will substitute the value of del W, that is your PdV, that is valid for the reversible process du. Then we will see this is again first law of thermodynamics. For the reversible process. For the reversible process, equation 4, equation 3 is valid for both the process, reversible as well as irreversible process. But equation 4 is valid only for reversible process. Then, if we will see the term U plus PV, the term U plus PV in thermodynamics appears frequently. So, for convenience, we write as U plus PV is equal to enthalpy H. So H is equal to U plus PV, or dH is equal to dU plus PdV plus V into dP. That is the change of enthalpy, equation 5. Then enthalpy H is extensive property. Its unit is kilojoule. Its unit is kilojoule, and specific enthalpy. Enthalpy, that is your small h, that is the ratio of capital H upon small h. Its unit is kilojoule per kg, is an intensive property. And H is equal to MCPT. Again, dH is equal to MCPdT. Equation 6. The fifth application of first law of thermodynamics, that is PMM1. It means perpetual motion machine of kind 1 is not possible. If we will see the perpetual motion machine, it is the machine which delivers works continuously without taking any input. If we will see this machine from any source, it will never take any type of input, and this one continue will supply the work output. If we will see the efficiency of PMM1 or perpetual motion machine of kind 1, we will see output upon input, that is W out upon work input. It means W out upon work input is equal to 0. PMM1 of kind 1 is equal to infinite. It means from PMM1 it is clear ki if PMM1 is possible, it will violate the first law of thermodynamics, and second is efficiency is infinite. But if you will see, you will check the first law of thermodynamics, then you will see if the heat is equal to 0, that work must be equal to 0. If it is not possible, it violate the first law of thermodynamics. So it is not possible. So it clear from first law of thermodynamic, the machine having infinite efficiency is not possible. That is the fifth application of first law of thermodynamics. Then next is free expansion. Free expansion. The expansion of a gas. Expansion of a gas against the vacuum is known as free expansion. If we will consider a closed insulated vessel, this one is your closed insulated vessel, and in one portion of the vessel gas is filled having some pressure, but in the second portion of the vessel a vacuum is created. Then suddenly partition is removed in the free expansion. Work done is equal to zero. In the free expansion, the work done will be equal to zero. And according to the first law of thermodynamics, vessel is completely closed insulated vessel. Then the heat transfer will be equal to zero. The heat transfer will be equal to zero. It means du is equal to zero, or u2 minus u1 is equal to zero, or u1 is equal to u2. In free expansion, internal energy remains constant. Work done is equal to zero. If you will see, in the free expansion, PdV is not zero, is not equal to zero. But the work done in free expansion, is zero, because PdV, this one is PdV is valid only for reversible process, but free expansion is irreversible process. Heat transfer in various process. process. First of all, we will check the heat transfer for constant, volume, process. For constant volume process, we know that according to first law of thermodynamic, del Q is equal to dU plus PdV. But you know very well in isochoric process, volume is equal to constant. So del Q will be equal to internal energy or MCP CV dT. Here the heat transfer will be equal to the internal energy change of the system. And if you will check the heat transfer for the constant pressure or isobaric process, then you will check for the constant pressure process del Q is equal to dU plus PdV. Or for the constant pressure process, you can write dU plus PV. Again, we know that enthalpy dS is equal to dU plus PdV plus VdV. But pressure is constant, so enthalpy will be equal to dU plus P into dV. Again, we will check equation 6 and equation 7. The heat transfer will be equal to the enthalpy will be equal to the MCP del T T. Equation 8. This one is equation 7 and this one 8 and this one is equation 9. Third, heat transfer for constant temperature or isothermal process. According to the first law of thermodynamics, we know that dU plus PdV or dU plus del W. But U is the function of temperature. When temperature is constant, so change of the internal energy will be equal to zero. So change of the internal energy will be equal to zero, or del Q, change of heat transfer or heat transfer will be equal to the, what is the work done in isothermal process? That is your equation 10. Then process 4, what will be the heat transfer for adiabatic process? For adiabatic process, and we know very well in adiabatic process the heat transfer del Q is equal to zero. And again, what will be the heat transfer in polytropic process? In polytropic process, del Q is equal to del W plus dU. And for the polytropic process is equal to MR T1 minus T2 upon N minus 1 plus D. DU is equal to MCV DT. Or again, if we will check, the CP minus CV is equal to R and CP y Cv is equal to gamma. We will compare the both, then we will find Cp is equal to gamma r upon gamma minus 1, and Cv is equal to r upon gamma minus 1. So substituting the value of Cv from the equation, the value of the Cv from equation, we will get m r gamma minus 1 into t2 minus t1, that is your dt. For this one is equal to m r is a common, t1 minus t2 is a common, 1 upon n minus 1 minus 1 upon gamma minus 1. This value will be equal to mr t1 minus t2 gamma minus n upon gamma minus 1 into n minus 1. So the work done in the polytropic process, tropic process, is equal to mr t1 minus t2 upon n minus 1 into gamma minus n upon gamma minus 1. So this one it's not work done, it is heat transfer in polytropic process. So heat transfer in polytropic process will be equal to gamma minus n upon gamma minus 1 into work done in polytropic process. That is the heat transfer in polytropic. That is